Greetings, this is SlotRex, and welcome back to Terroir, the wine making, the wine growing, grape growing, Chateau Life Simulation. We did just make a fairly decent wine. It does kind of, it is sad there is no record of all of your wines, but we have made four five-star wines in the lifetime of our thing. We do have 54,000. I'm really inclined to take the chance, add that, and hopefully we will be able to plant. Now, if we plant Cabernet Sauvignon in this one, we will have two completely different types of grapes. Now, I'm not 100% sure how we're going to go with it. Our renown is actually going up. That's going to start getting complicated, isn't it? Okay, so we do know how to grow the Chardonnay. That is good. I do know how to do that. We can. So which vine is got rot? This one again? It's always this one's got rot. So this definitely is going to become a much more complicated game now that we've got. We are still selling stuff, which is good. Do we have any more to sell at all? I don't think we do. We have none. We have no barrels and no bottles whatsoever. So the Chardonnay is this one. It's 5 years old. We're on three already. It is spring. I mean, that's not too bad. I'm actually going to go do and do and do and do and get that down to there because that is light foliage. It has only. So we got a total yield of 0.88, but it doesn't really tell us the total yield of each of these. So that's going to be interesting. This is the first time I've ever had more than one thing. And the next time we'll be aiming for the clay or the sandy. No. Because I'm not actually sure how we get these ones to be right, but we do know how to grow the Chardonnay, and that is good. That is good because we should go up one because it is summer. It is cloudy, but we are on light foliage, so that should go up. I'm wondering if this is the same. It could be the same. It really could. I just still feel like I should be drinking wine while I do this. But coffee will have to do. Now, that one does not have any rot. That one doesn't anymore either. We're up to 1.89 total yield. It is. I'm looking forward to seeing how complicated this. And clay's the one. No. I think as they get older, we have to trim them more. Do I have to harvest them all? We do have to harvest them all at the same time. So the Cabernet Sauvignon, we got 3 body, 3 tannin, 3 sweetness. So that's, I mean, not fantastic. I thought it was the Chardonnay that got the rot there. Anyway, so that's done. Let's squish them. I guess we can only squish with the one. One or more varieties doesn't have a. Oh, it's up there. Okay. So this is how we're going to have to do it. I was curious how this was going to work. So that's going. I might let this one grow out a little bit because we didn't get. Because I don't really know how that works. So maybe we do actually have to do that a little bit differently. All right. So we want to get. We're going to leave that one to ferment less than a month. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, I should have worked that out for both. Okay. So we want to put the acidity up a little bit. And we'll get that to there. The Chardonnay, we kind of know how to do this. We want to get the acidity up to 50-50. That'll put it up 5, so they'll go tonight. We put it to there, it'll go there. We'll get the tan down. So that, I think, is going to be right for that. I don't really know if this is. All right. Now, we're going to wait for the acidity on that one to go down. We're going to go. I'm going to assume that I don't want the tannins to go down too much though, but we don't know how to make a good Cab Sav, but the good thing is we can afford to throw it away. That is the most important thing, is we can actually afford to throw it away. So is that October? Did anything go down here? So we want, no, we definitely need it to leave it till October, November, potentially December. Potentially December, but we'll check in November, and we're going to let this one grow out because I really need to make sure we work out how to do it. I'm going to let both of them go for one more month. So December. December we're going to do that. December we're going to bottle the lot. And we'll see how well I've picked, because I really don't know how to grow this one whatsoever. Alright, let's have a look. I'm going to bottle this one. I'm pretty... Now, Chardonnay is this and this. 3,000. This one we're going to bottle, and we're just going to do screw cap and normal. Now we jump in here, we'll do organize a tasting. Now, we got to stick with El Scorchito. Actually, no, look, let's go with all these. Ooh, we've got some three-star ones now. So let's do that. We'll invite them to the tasting. Well, we got perfect for a meal, enjoyed al fresco on a mild summer afternoon. So we got 4.5. Not super fantastic, but we will sell. We've got 600, so let's sell. Look, let's sell 300 to that one and 300 to that one. We're going to sell that. We'll go done. We're going to organize a tasting of this one. And I'm actually going to get, we're going to get Fern Bosch. We're going to get Scorchito and Caleb, because we kind of know those guys. What? Yeah, it's great. I mean, aren't all cab savs great? Well, I think it's great. So we did okay with that one. So this one, we've got 480. Let's give them 384. And we've got distributor relations of all of them now. And we've still got some bottles left. And I mean, that seems like that went okay. I do wonder, 100,000 that's going to cost. Our lifetime revenue is only 111,000. Latest financial report. Tavern sales, property sales. Okay, so worker actions. So there's a lot of other stuff coming out, like winemakers workshop and things like that, which we've got no idea about, but I'm assuming that's because we haven't got that. And this looks still locked down here. Which one's got fungal rot? This one? No, cab sav. So I guess it is the one that it's below. And what happens once you've got like 33 different tiles? Or is it not lots of vineyards that you get? Is it lots of other types of buildings? So we're not making as much money as I kind of hoped. January, let's see what happens in February. We went backwards. Are you guys not selling my wine? I mean, it's not bad wine. I mean, they're still selling some. The distributor relations have gone down. Is it still happening, like, where I click on it? Look, if I do it again, is it going to go down again? No, it didn't. Good. Good, 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 good. Okay, so we're in February. Things are about to change. Things are about to start growing. Let's see if we can actually grow. Oh, look, our money's going up again. That's good. 20. Now it's going down again. At least we sold something. But if we get another couple of, like, five-star wines, we should be pretty good. So, like I said, we know how to grow this one. We know how to grow this one. There hasn't been much rain, though. In fact, there's been none. So, we're getting some rain. I might let it go to optimal foliage, because it should grow to optimal foliage now. I really wish that we wouldn't get rot. But I'm thinking if we let it go to optimal, like, say it's gone down because we've got heavy foliage and it's I wish that you could kind of see. It is kind of hard to tell the difference, and I think okay, that's on optimal. Okay, so we're gonna do a bit of a test here. We're gonna take you back to no foliage and no foliage is what we're gonna do. So they've both got no foliage. It is summer, so hopefully, if I remember correctly, we should get here. Yeah, we get two. So hopefully, I've got this right because July, August, we should be harvesting both of them at. It was clear. We should be harvesting them both at six, which should be pretty much perfect. Which means I might have actually got something right for a change. We're bordering out at seven because we didn't have enough. Please let me just harvest. Don't go any higher. Okay, we harvested at a relatively good level. Both of those are something that I can definitely deal with. That's fine. So let's go to that one and that one. We'll crush our grapes. We do have $29,000, so we are starting to slowly make a little bit of money. And I don't know whether we should spread to this or we should concentrate on upgrading our chateau first. Probably that. And we want to get our sweetness down, so we're going to get sweetness down to. Get sweetness down to five. Sweetness down to two. That's for our Chardonnay. And we're gonna get our sweetness down to. Look, let's get our. Yep. 3 months for both of them. Now, that's gonna take a while. The good thing is, we may still have some wine to sell. Can we sell any of this stuff? We could sell all of them to Farron Brothers. And now we've got a relationship with them of a little bit higher. We've got 19 bottles left. We'll sell some to them. And four to them. I mean, I guess that should get us a little bit more money. We do have 20. We should have enough to get all of this done. It's just a matter of fermenting it and then doing the next few calculations right, because we don't know anything whatsoever about Cab Sav, and definitely now that we're starting to ferment things longer. Things are going to be happening in the year when we're supposed to be concentrating on the vines. I have no idea how you are in any way supposed to keep up with 33 tiles unless there is some automation that you can do where you can hire some workers to keep them at, say, optimal, or you can keep them on light foliage, but we'll find out. So it's already December and we haven't even got the fermentation right yet because we wanted to get the sweetness down. I know so little about wine. I really do feel like a wine playing this, though. All right. Now, it's gonna get to get it down. It's gonna get two tannins. So we're gonna begin that one, and I'm gonna go the same on both of those. Same on both of those, and of course we have to have the same barrel type. So. Tannins are going to go down to a city down one. So if we wait 2 months, I think they're both going to come out okay. So it is December, January, February. I think February, bottling February, we should work out okay. Once again, I know nothing and I'm just trying to work this out. I do wonder how we're supposed to ever make $100,000. I guess if you made two five-star wines in a row, but we are also starting to get access with more renown to some. Oh, almost forgot to some. Oh, so we got buttery on that one. Okay, we're gonna bottle this one, and it's Cab Sav. We're gonna do a cork because it makes it worth more, and we're gonna bottle this one. It's a cork and a white. We're gonna bottle that, and we're gonna organize a tasting. And as I said, we are starting to get some of these higher up. Arena Hazia, Pauline McGood, and we've got to get our old friend El Scorchito. Good Cab Sav is everywhere, but great ones are rare, just like this little gem. Absolutely brilliant. So let's organize a tasting for this one, and let's just go all out and just get the 3-star. Pauline Malgood. So we got 4.5, that's pretty good. Delectable, perfect from first sip to final swig. So I actually think we did okay there. Now here's the thing, like, is there more of these? Because if I sell 150 of those, but then I go done, and then I go up to this one. We can't sell. We might have to start selling them in smaller chunks. We can't. What's this? As long as your distributor relations are at 5, you will be able to sell 100% of your bottles to Haogang. What does that mean? As long as your distributor relations are at 5, man, Hat will buy me ones for 10% more. Okay, so getting them up does different things. Okay, so we've got 1,200 bottles. So that should make us some money, but I'm not 100% sure how we're ever going to be able to keep it unless there's some more distributors that come once we've actually got them. So we've only got 540 of those. We've got 210 of those. We could probably... Okay, yep. So we just have to keep an eye on that. I kind of wish there was an indicator somewhere where we could work with that. So where we got optimal. So if we can keep it on optimal... So optimal, I guess we can look at it and there's no leaves sticking out. Maybe that's the way, because I guess it kind of looks like there's leaves sticking out anyway. Let's see if we can see a total yield's not all that great. And we are in the middle of spring already. Let's have a look. See, like, they're currently growing. It's optimal foliage. I guess there's no leaves sticking out the top. They're grapes that are sticking out. Let's have a quick look in here because it will pause it. See if there's any we can sell to anybody. Okay, we can sell 210 to you. And we can sell 540 to you. I mean, there you go. We can get big chunks of stuff done. Okay. Oh, you can press space to pause it. But. I'm confused by how this works. So we're still not. They look the same. Optimal and heavy are very, very hard to tell the difference too. So we're going to come into May, June. I mean, we might have to start. Yeah, we definitely, the older they get, the faster they grow. So you do have to trim them more. That is definitely happening with this one, which is 7 years old. This one is only 2. Okay, so that was cloudy. I'm just going to take you down to no foliage because we have no ripeness whatsoever. And hopefully that should go to 3. Okay, so July is going to be completely clear. So that should go to 4. We should be okay. Yep, we're going to be fine. And August, we might even, if we're lucky, get it to 5 for both of them. Which means we're kind of monitoring that relatively well, I guess. Oh, it's going to rain, isn't it? Which means they're probably going to go to optimal. No, it's fine. We'll get them at 4. That's interesting. We haven't had 4 in a while. So we got, what, 5 sweetness. Actually, that might be even better. We might be able to get that done even quicker. So we'll do piggyage. There, what are we at? 6. We're at 60,000. Which means we're doing pretty good, I think. Alright. Less than a month. Leave to ferment less than a month. Alright. Now, we want... let's think. If we get that to 5... to 6, and we get that to 6. If we do that, we'll get both of them to 7 on acidity, and now we'll just choose the normal barrel type because it's the only thing we've got. We'll get the acidity down to 6. The tannins will, however, drop down to 4 in 1 month, and then we'll be able to bottle them and see how we do. We do have $59,000, which is good, so I don't think we're going to go broke, even if we don't make the best wine that we could. I wonder if... I mean, it'd be nice to have a lake, but that's... I mean, it is... It would be nice to have it, because then they'd be immune to stuff for the first 50 years of their life. But also, do we really... Ooh, I almost forgot. Bottle. That's the Chardonnay, so we will go there and cork. That is the Cab Sav, so we'll go there and the cork. And let's organise a tasting, and I don't know how well we're going to go, but we're going to get Kramer, Sia, and Malgood. Okay, so not the greatest. Let's organize a tasting on this one. So if we get El Scorchito, who's our best friend, we get Herezia and Malgood. Let's see. Yes, it's great. I mean, aren't all cabsets. So they both did relatively well. Now, as long as your distributor relations are at 5, so we can sell 960 bottles of that one wine to them. And that means we will be able to split these ones up. So this one, they'll buy it for more, but if we give them 500 and we give them 580, I don't know how to get those distributor ratings up, but we'll see what we can do. So we got 47,000. I don't know how well we're going to do with this, but we should be able to get one entire season in before the end of the episode, at least one more. I much prefer having them come in at about 7 rather than 4. They did not work as well. Her renown is 21. I mean, we are making money. I mean, not all wine has to be perfect. Sometimes you have to have some... Sometimes you have to have some dodgy ones. Sometimes you have to have some cheap ones. But it would be nice if we had some kind of... I don't know, rain or something, because I guess we could buy this at 75, but I also kind of want to save up for that, but I also don't want to do that till we've, I mean, we could buy it right now, but I mean, then we're going to go broke, aren't we? We don't want to go broke. I really, Q&A should do this. It really should. It would make it so much better. We have a total yield of 0. But I guess that's because of the time of... Oh, beautiful, it's raining. So that'll give us a little bit of foliage. Now, we've got to remember that as these get older, we do need to keep more, take more care of them. But I think you do get better tools as you research. And I think, yeah, saving up for this is going to be the most important. So we're at optimal and optimal. We're just going to run on that for this grow. March 2025. I'd love to just sit and watch grapes grow. Be awesome. I think it's a... Yeah. Now let's have a look. That's heavy, and that's heavy. So what we want to do... That's optimal. That's heavy. So 3? Yeah, so it took 3 trims to get it to optimal. I kind of feel that... Let's just go to light. Oh man, look at that. That took ages. So we've made it to light foliage. It's May. It's coming into June, so let's see if we can get some brightness going. No. No way. 2, 3, 4. 4. It took 4. We do have 100,000, so the truth of the matter is if we really, really, really wanted to, we could buy the Chateau. Oh, but we don't have the Renown, do we? So we could buy that. Let's see at the end of this if we could buy... Because what kind of wine does this make? Merlot and Pinot Noir. I actually like Merlot. Really hanging out for no foliage for you. Because we need you to ripen up. Well, really, did you have to? Come on, come on, come on. We need you to... Come on. Come on. We need you to... Yep, 5. I'm okay with 5. definitely okay with 5. We're going to get to the end of August. We're going to be able to... I would have preferred 6. I would really have preferred 6, but we're going to take the 5. Grapes were exceptional. Grapes were exceptional. Perfectly happy with that. Man, I would have been so much better if we could have afforded the other, but... Let's see how the wines turn out, and then we might buy that in winter and grow it anyway, because we still need to actually go through all this process here. So, we're going to get sweetness down to 5. Sweetness down to 5. This can hurt, this fermentation here. We had it, I think it was the beginning of this episode, we had like we had to do 3 months. But I think we got reasonable wines out of it, but it did definitely make a struggle. So we got 99, we really could buy that. All right. Now, it's gonna get rid of 2 tannins. So if we get that to there, and that to there, and we begin pressing, that won't take very long at all. We'll go in here, we're gonna choose that because we have to. Now we're gonna go to 6 acidity, 5 tannins. So it is October. Did that happen straight away? It did. So this is, contrary to popular belief, it doesn't taste like dirt. Earthy flavors grant 10%. Okay, so we're going to bottle this one. That is the Chardonnay. Cork it. Cork it. That is quite a bit of money. Let's organize a tasting for this one. Let's take a risk. Let's get Kramer and Malgood to do it. Ooh, delectable. Perfect from the first sip to the final swig. The only person... I mean, Pauline Malgood gave us a high score. So let's go down this way. Organize a taste. Now, this one I'm intrigued by. So we're gonna take Kramer. We're going to take Malgood. I mean, I guess if we did all these, we might... Let's take off Sia and Treskel and... Good Cabernet Sauvignon is everywhere, but great ones are... We got a full score on that one. So this one... Now we can go to... 432 on that one. But I'm not sure if that's really a good idea. So we'll do that one. We'll sell that. We're up to 5. We'll go done on that, but we'll go up to this one because we'll have quite a few bottles of this, and we'll do, I don't know, 864 with you, and we'll do 216 with you. And I don't know why we can't get a good distributor rating with you. We have $90,000. I feel like this is worth it. Let's go for it. And let's see if we can plant this one. We are at the end of another episode. We'll be starting the next one with... what's this one? This one is... It's not loam. We got loam, sandy, and clay, I think it is. Clay. Yes, so we've got a clay. So we'll be back in the very next episode of Terroir with trying to run 3 grapevines at the same time. As always, guys, thank you so much for watching. Any hints or questions or suggestions or whatsoever, please do leave them down below in the comments. Like, subscribe, all that jazz. I'll see you guys next time.